أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم حمدا لله ثم الصلاة والسلام على محمد وعلى أهلي وصحبه أجمعين وبeloved brothers and sisters in faith السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Let me tell you something you might not know, that Ramadan is an embodification of the old institution of Islam. It comes to test your iman. Remember the verse where Allah says, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا إيمان آمنوا قتب عليكم الصيام. So it comes to test your faith and add extra bolts of piety. After iman comes salah. So Ramadan comes to increase your observance of salah. You do not want to miss the beneficial nawafil, the tarawih, the witr, and many more. Then zakah. This is our point of discuss today, inshallah. Then Saum itself, the heart of the month, is fasting and hajj. Is there anything to represent hajj in Ramadan? Yes, there is the itikaf. So journeying in the houses of Allah, the masajid, and devoting oneself to ibadah during the last 10 nights and days of Ramadan. These we can use to represent al-hajj, the fifth pillar of Islam, embodified in Ramadan. You see, it is a complete institution of purification and submission. At this time of the month, what concerns us is the zakat al-fitr. Reports from the Sahaba of the Prophet, may Allah be pleased with them, and may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, indicate that every independent Muslim who can afford to feed himself, ourselves, and his our families on the day and night of Eid, and has at least a sa' more food, equivalent to about 2.2 kilograms of extra staple food, must give out zakat al-fitr. Zakah in itself is a form of purification. Hence, this zakat al-fitr aims to cleanse your fast and rectify the inadequacies in them, as well as provide for others the means to rejoice, merry, and be filled on the day of feasting and merriment. The deadline for observing zakat al-fitr is the morning of Eid before the Eid prayer. However, it is beneficial to observe it very early before the day of Eid. Understanding the wisdom behind giving out these alms, some scholars consent to giving out a proportionate amount of money instead of staples. That is, if one cannot provide or find the staple food or foodstuff as initially said, and Allah knows best. But ensure you give someone else a reason to be happy and eat after 29 or 30 days of Ladashia's fasting. It should also be said that this zakah is based on each individual. It is not a family or household thing. It is one sa' of staple food per one fasting Muslim in the family. So as a self-supporting Muslim, maybe as a parent or an independent child, consider the number of those dependent on you multiplied by about 2.2 kilograms, and the result is how much of zakah you're liable to give out, provided that you and your family have more than enough to eat on the day and night of Eid, and Allah knows best. In the spirit of feasting and marrying, remember not to indulge in prohibited acts. You do not celebrate halal with haram. Consider what you eat, what you drink, what you wear, what you watch, what you listen to, your hairstyle for both males and females. You've used many days to squeeze the sweet milk out of a cow into a bowl. Don't kick the bowl of milk in your act of jubilation. Remember that earning the pleasure of Allah comes first. And who knows, this may be your last Ramadan, and it may be mine. It's a few minutes to iftar again today, alhamdulillah. Let's remember to supplicate. On this day I say, oh Allah, the majestic, accept our worship and perfect our deeds. Give us the full rewards of the little we could do. Spare our lives to witness more of this, and keep us safe within the fold of Islam, O Allah, the ever living. For now, I live in the mercy of Allah Azza wa Jal, wa sallallahu ala Muhammad, wa ala ahli wa sahbihi, wa salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.